share with you today is titled Discernment.
As you know, I always do give some definitions of the word discernment. Please make notes in this word. It's going to bless you. It's going to be a good study guide for you to study throughout the week. I've got four definitions of the word discernment. Please make note of this. Discernment is the ability to obtain sharp or accurate perception or to make good judgment. For example, if you had a box, a square box in front of your face, and that box has six sides, and each side has a number, your perception is from the side that you are seeing. So if your side is seeing number one, the number one side of the box, that is the only perception that you see. And that is not discernment. But discernment is to obtain sharp perception. That is, you see that box from every angle. You see the top, the bottom, the sides, and you see the back. And so when you have a good perception of something, you can then make good judgment. So you need to be able to see something from all angles to fully understand it in depth. And once you have that, that is when you can make good judgment. The second one is this. Discernment is the ability to see what the naked eye cannot see. The third definition is this. Discernment is the ability to see or understand or to sense what others don't see or overlook. The fourth definition is this. A person with discernment is considered to possess great wisdom and to be of good judgment. So discernment, the fourth definition, is wisdom. Hallelujah. People of wisdom generally have great discernment. They can generally see the end of something before it even happens. They can put themselves in the right position to receive a blessing before it's even begun to manifest.